Also Aspern, die U-Bahn-Station.
The Aspern North subway station is something like a UFO that has landed on a large empty field. It has a form with much pathos, an insane entry which actually goes out onto a green meadow. Stefan Huber senses an incredibly strange, surreal disappointment, which he also finds great. There's something Kafkaesque about it, which he really likes. The whole thing is set in the backdrop of a new commuter town, which is under construction, and which will be very busy when it's completed. Yet, the artist likes it better now.
Wir stehen hier in der Station Aspern Nord.
Martina Teig tells how Stefan Huber won the art competition for the installation in the Aspern Nord subway station. The choice was made by an independent five-member panel of national and international experts. Martina Teig is the managing director of the municipal organization Kunst im öffentlichen Raum Wien. Kür, or Public Art Vienna. The mission of the organization is to revive entire urban spaces with temporary and permanent contemporary art.
Temporäre zeitgenössische künstlerische Projekte umsetzen.
Stefan Huber found the cooperation between Kür and Wiener Linien, Vienna's transport company, perfect. Everyone there put a lot of heart and soul into the project. It made him incredibly happy.
Kunst ist ja nicht das Kerngeschäft der Wiener Linien. Ich habe aber die Ehre und Freude,
Art is not the core business of Wiener Linien. The company, therefore, doesn't want to interfere in the art's content. Johann Hödel says that Kür has the art specialists, thus their cooperation. He is pleased to be able to support the implementation of art projects. Hundreds of thousands of passengers use the subway every day and thus make the subway station Vienna's largest museum. The response has been uniformly positive. The subway station consists of a relatively broad platform. At each end, there are large walls. On each of these, the artist has installed a map collage of 60 square meters. Between these maps are colorful lines with the life data of important personalities from Viennese history. One map revolves around the year 1809, when the Austrians defeated Napoleon at the Battle of Aspern-Essling. The other map is based on 1912, the year Aspern opened Europe's then largest airport. A tiny suburb of Vienna, Aspern has twice written world history. Stefan Huber tells about these two points in history with his maps. High culture interests this artist much less than pop culture. It's about an oscillation between high culture and pop culture, and between humor and seriousness. He also tells stories about the population in Vienna's suburbs. This interests people today, and they read about it on the maps. On maps, Stefan Huber is fascinated that they are the most abstract and at the same time the most objective representation of the world. And we can read this abstraction with its lines and colors.
Also ich gehe ja fast gottgleich vor, indem ich
neue Landschaften erschaffe, by creating new landscapes.
Was mir auf der Welt nicht gefällt, kann ich weglassen oder ich kann irgendwie was sozusagen neu dazu erfinden. Ich wollte aber nicht in der U-Bahn-Station,
dass Menschen, die mich überhaupt nicht zu tun haben, sich vom Kopf gestoßen sind und dann sagen, ja, ich will eine arrogante Haltung, was will der Arrogant sagen.
Ich erzähle ganz subjektiv eine Geschichte über die Stadt Wien, was mich fasziniert. So wie meine Kartografie auch subjektiv ist.
As for details on the maps, there are the dance steps of the Viennese Waltz. Much more comprehensive is Count Metternich. From Metternich's two control centers, an entire system of eyes and ears runs through the whole map. This control freak had everything but artists, writers, the old suburbs, but also his own subordinates. Everywhere on the map there are these nerves with eyes and ears. There are many more such details. On the 1809 map, he talks about Kyselak, the first tagger created a kind of graffiti in the Hofburg, among other places. In 1912 comes Charney Breitwieser, who robbed a lot of banks, but contributed some of his loot to the poor. Vienna was much more of a melting pot, as they say about New York. At the end of the 19th century, Eastern European Jews brought an incredible new world and intellectuality to Vienna. And Hitler, Lenin, Stalin, Trotsky, Freud, Karl Kraus, Alfred Adler, Gustav Mahler, Gustav Klimt. They were all here at the same time. Here, European culture and history has taken place in all its variations, from the very tragic to utopias. The state of Israel was, as it were, developed by Herzl in Vienna. The city is an incredible energy field of human history.